You've been put in charge of running heck, an afterlife for terrible people who aren't quite evil enough to get into hell. What are some of the tortures you design? All earbuds will have one side broken. Earbuds but one side cuts out every 30 seconds. You need to hold them in a special way to make them work. You know when you feel itchy, so you scratch yourself, but then, after you scratch one itch, you're itchy somewhere else. And it's not a strong itch, it's just barely strong enough for you to want to scratch it. Yeah, that. Forever. All the soda you want, but it's always flat and room temperature. Every fork is missing two tines. You get a new pair of shoes, but one shoe sole is 1/4 inch thicker than the other. Every key is bent just a little bit, but every time you use it, it bends a little bit more. When it finally breaks, it will break off inside the lock, and the one locksmith in heck is busy with everyone else's broken keys. But stay on the line, your call is important to us. You have to flip every USB connection 4 times before it goes in, and if you disconnect without ejecting it first, you lose all the data on the drive permanently. Farts are now as contagious as yawns, and Fridays are what we call bean extravaganza. Every day will have mandatory show tune hour. Every smartphone will have a pre-cracked screen. Pictures hung on the wall will never be perfectly straight. Tables and chairs will always be a little bit wobbly. Laundry is still ever so slightly damp, and it has that smell. A TV with one channel, a logo bouncing around that never hits the corner, and the TV is indestructible, because you know that after a few years of watching that, people are going to start getting violent. Everyone's speech is lagging 1 second behind their lip movements, you fucking monster. Forcing them to stare at cups that are way too close to the edge, like almost falling, but they aren't. Edit. Typo. Assuming I'm given powers, then I'd choose the ability to strap them in a chair and tell a story that goes on forever and never quite gets to the point and goes on infinite tangents, and when I reach the end of infinity I lose my train of thought and go, guess I gotta start over. Everything has a layer of dust, but there is no way to clean any of it unless you wipe it off with your hands. This leads to there still being some dust always stuck in cracks and corners that will never be reachable. I make an amazing and addictive TV series with ups, downs, success, failure, love, hate, and everything in between. These great storylines, these great characters, everything is amazing. And when the series is about to end, earlier in the day before the finale airs that ties up all the loose ends and gives ending to everyone, I cancel it. Their socks keep falling down inside their shoes. Instead of devils with pitchforks, they get toddlers and babies with sharp, sharp baby fingernails, and they are obliged to care for these toddlers and babies, who vomit or throw tantrums all the time. I've got it, said Satan, and grinned with delight. May all of their sneezes arrive in the night. May all of their tables be tippy, he cried. May of all their laces be loose and untied. May all of their digits be stubbed till they bleed. May all of their captures be vexing to read. May all of their dinners be slow to defrost. May all of their keys be departed and lost. May all of their cues be unbearably long, forever relentlessly stuck on a song. Forever upsetting and spilling their drink. Forever no step on the stair where they think. He giggled, demented, and wiggled with joy. He chuckled, contented, and pleased with his ploy. He danced and he bopped and he bounded and bounced. And let there be stones in their shoes, he announced. Dinner is a nice, succulent juicy steak, say a 2-inch cut of porterhouse or ribeye, baked potatoes on the side, along with some asparagus. A perfect red wine is paired with the steak. Everything is covered in ketchup. They have to eternally scroll down a Facebook feed with nothing but repetitive baby photos and oversharing minion memes. Then an ad pops up which forces the page to the beginning again. Whether they're a frontie or a backie doesn't matter. The moment their back is turned, the toilet paper gets automatically switched to the opposite of their preference. We all know that all backies go to hell anyway. They get to play an average online video game, not a terrible one. But it's constantly lagging. Not horrific lag either, that would be hell. Just enough to affect their skill without being completely unplayable. Give them a TV that has 2 channels. One shows a live feed of what's happening in heaven and the other for hell. There is nothing else to do. You constantly feel slightly nauseous and all the floors are trampolines. That's hell, not heck. All beds have only the scratchiest of wool blankets, and they are too short to cover your feet and upper torso at the same time. Every time you reach for a pen or pencil, it's never the one you intended to pick up. The tea will always be too milky. That's a British hack exclusive. The Americans in heck will get too milky tea, and the British in heck will get way over sweet and cold tea. All of the volumes are left on an odd number. They'll have to sleep on a bed that's too cold without the blanket, but too hot with the blanket with no fan to balance it out. You have to listen to someone incorrectly explain to someone else how to use a piece of technology that you are an expert at. Every drink is lukewarm. All music you listen to cuts out right before the climax. A couple of things and probably more once I come up with them. They are lust for the one food they could not withstand in life and go shopping, but shopping carts block the entire pathway. You can see the object but never reach it, nor leave the store until closing time. On the intercom, dancing in the streets is playing on repeat. The pavement is divided between tiles with an X on them and tiles without an X. Stepping on tiles with an X makes your shoes slash socks so wet they won't dry for 6 hours. Tiles without an X have dog poop on them. Every Friday there's a slideshow event that's mandatory to visit and lasts 36 hours. Flushing the toilet is only possible once a day. Both sides of their pillows are always hot. Ordered pizza always says pulling up now on the tracker, but in reality still takes 3 hours. Your nose is constantly really itchy, but every time you try to scratch your nose, your finger smells like poop. Let them use the internet to look up things, however it has to be a 56k download speed, and the mouse is an old school trackball one that is constantly dirty and catches every so often, and no matter how much you clean it, it will never be smooth. Their phone cord constantly connects and disconnects every couple seconds while they're sleeping and buzzes each time it reconnects. One huge line of people, slowly moving forward towards a door. When you get through, there's another huge line of people. You'd start socializing with people around you, but they've been there so long they are super paranoid about you trying to take their spot. Everyone is one bad move away from a complete meltdown, but somehow the tension keeps everyone in line. Pun intended, you're thirsty and hungry, but you can't step out. You're tired, but there's no wait, so sit down and rest. Their socks'll have one hole in the toe of their dominant foot. They always have minty breath. Like after brushing your teeth, heck, part involves milk and orange juice. Only, no other options. Treadmill. But if they're being bad, then treadmill with Legos. He said heck, not hell. Fine. Treadmill with Lego, that you can avoid if you're paying constant attention. Every pen is almost out of ink, the ones where you have to scribble heaps for it to work and then you can only write about 3 letters. Every time they're about to walk through a door, someone holds it open for them when they're still just that bit too far away that they have to speed up so it's awkward. And every time they pass through a door, they have to hold it open for someone else who is just that awkward distance away too. All tissue paper must have brown streaks printed on each square of paper so that people never know if they've wiped enough or not. There's always a pebble in your shoe, but when you look, there's nothing there. Walking around constantly in socks they can't take off with the floor covered in 2 millimeters of water. Co-workers are allowed into heck to ask a never-ending series of work-related questions that they should have the answers to or can find themselves. Always have a nostril clogged for 23 hours every day. Baby shark playing on repeat all the time. Every time you go to get a snack, there are only the little broken pieces left in the bag. A shower they have to stand in that's just a few degrees hotter than where they want it, or never gets quite hot enough for your liking. It takes 4 tries to get the USB plug the right way. Oh my god, am I living in heck right now? The toilet paper isn't an arm's length of the seat. You know how when there is too much pollen in the air and it makes your eyes feel uncomfortable? Just that, forever. You can listen to any music, but it has to be the kids' bop version. Every time someone wash hands, their sleeve will get slightly wet. They're stuck in that pre-sneeze feeling for weeks. The toilets all have one sheet of toilet paper left. You have an uneven amount of socks. Even if you throw out just one sock, another one magically disappears to come back to an uneven amount. Every door you ever open will jam. Even if it opens fine for someone else, when you touch a door, it jams. Except when it doesn't. So you just look like you really aggressively opened a door. Every pencil you own has the lead broken. Every pen you own blotches ink, and every eraser you own smears. One shoe is a half size too small, the other a half size too large. Every time you leave your house, a kid on a razor scooter hits your shins. All beds are a little too short. All television programs are dubbed in Polish. Everything is slightly inconvenient. Waiting for something, it's just slightly later than you needed. Having food, it's always slightly too warm or too cold. Clothes, they don't quite fit, always a bit too tight. Want a beer? It's slightly too warm and the head is too big. Chair and table legs are just slightly too hard to judge, so you stub your toe constantly. Using a computer takes a while to load. Using a phone freezes a lot. All screens are slightly greasy and can't be cleaned. Out of every pair of socks, one is always slightly damp while the other has a huge hole. You hear construction around your house constantly. During every meal, at least one bite always falls off the fork right before you bite. Chargers only work if you're not using whatever's plugged in. You always feel the urge to crack your knuckles, but they can't crack. There is always a slow driver in front of them. Always. Not bad. Just 3 to 4 miles per hour slower than they want to go. And on highways, slower, and inconsistent speeds. No cruise control in my heck. Always have the taste of just swallowing bad milk. Always missing on stitch in a row while knitting. Always having the feeling of a hair in your mouth. You can never fix the drippy faucet. Always out of meatloaf. Only have the end pieces of bread. All tacos have soggy shells. Every time you count something, you are one off. There is no cool side of your pillow. One nostril is always clogged. You can never find the last puzzle piece. You always behind a Karen in a line. One fingernail is always too short. Dude, this shit is my dorm. You have been visited by the smart studying doggo. You'll be blessed with good grades only if you subscribe to comment awards and like the video.
PG.
On top, food chain, won't stop, new game, hot box, that blue haze, one lock, two chains, no bras, two bays, mic drop, new stage, lights in my rear view, five cops, food race, faster than a Tesla, they say I'm exhausted.